What's up guys, Leopold the Brave here. Now this isn't a typical video I usually make, I'm not really making it with the viewers in mind. This video is more for the people this video is actually about, the cartoon reactors. I know reaction channels get a lot of flack for what they do, but I personally find cartoon reaction channels to be very interesting. Seeing how different people respond to different things that I used to respond to when I was younger watching all this stuff. So I'm gonna be counting down my top 5 favorite cartoon reaction channels and giving feedback on what I think. What I like about them, what I think they could do a little better, and just stuff that could overall help them improve. They can even have permission to react to this video if they want and discuss it with their fans. So I'll go over each reactor one at a time, giving them info and feedback and even some recommendations for stuff they might like to react to. And then at the end of the countdown, just some extra stuff for all of them that they might want to see. And one more thing, if you cartoon reactors are watching this, don't worry about your placement or any criticisms I give. I love all the channels on this list and only want to see them get better. So with that said, let's begin. Number 5 is TheFlamingShark. Now, overall, there isn't a ton to say because he's generally good all around. But there are two positives I want to point out. One of the big positives is that he's a very expressive reactor, but you can tell that he's not overdoing it. It's easy to see that his reactions are genuine, and he's immersing himself into the worlds that he's reacting to. The second positive is that he's very dedicated with his wide variety of content. If he says he's gonna do something, he does do it. The only problem is when he does that, and that leads us into one of the negatives. The lack of communication. Now there have been tons of times where the Flaming Shark has set up a schedule and has not been able to follow through with it. And that's completely understandable, people have their own lives and do their own things. But we never get to hear anything until after it's all fixed, so we're mostly left in the dark. Now I understand him not wanting to participate in the comment section because spoilers for the stuff he's reacting to, but there's like no other way to keep track of channel updates. He does have a Twitter, but he hasn't used it in over 2 years. And occasionally there's just a little more info I'd like to know now and then. For example, Adventure Time once got delayed for 3 weeks in a row. Meanwhile, everything was perfectly on schedule. Adventure Time was my personal favorite thing he reacted to, so it was a bummer to be left out in the dark for so long. But overall, the Flaming Shark, if you're watching this, love your content, especially Adventure Time, and I can't wait to see more. As for recommendations, I'd say give Invader Zim a try. I recall you once mentioning in a video that you had never seen it before and might give it a try someday, and yeah, that would be super awesome, Invader Zim is great! Considering how much you like the weird aspects of Adventure Time, Invader Zim will definitely be a treat with how bizarre it can get. Number 4 is Kick Butt Reactions. Sorry, but I prefer not to curse on my channel, but yeah, it's the other word, not butt. Now, overall, he's pretty similar to the Flaming Shark in terms of his expressiveness and the type of content he reacts to. But he does have a little bit more of my personal favorites, like Regular Show, and he does react to a bit more movies. I really loved his Coco reaction, it was like seeing the movie for the first time all over again. Then finally, he's pretty good at countering copyright, which is ironic because his channel recently got taken down, and he just came back. But what I mean by that is, he had all of his stuff backed up so he can just bring it back just like that. And he's very good with external links and fixing dead links. He even helped the Flaming Shark with some of his. Now my negative for him is that his content is a bit unbalanced. Like I said before, my personal favorite is Regular Show, and I'm not really a fan of Ruby or My Little Pony. And he could totally still react to those, I'm not complaining about that, not upset with what he's watching. It's just that occasionally we get like 3 Rubies and then 4 My Little Ponies and then a Regular Show. And then 3 more Rubies and 3 more My Little Ponies. And then by the time we got back to Regular Show, it was maybe 1 or 2 episodes at a time. But overall, I do enjoy his channel a lot, it's just not a very balanced breakfast, if you know what I'm saying. As for recommendations, definitely more animated movies. Try to find stuff you haven't seen before, no matter how old it is. Reactors tend to get bonus points in my book for more unique stuff. Number 3 is The Anime Youngin, and yeah, I know anime, cartoons, blah blah blah, I just like to keep them together since they're both animation. But yeah, one of the things I like about him is his more unique content. Instead of the typical My Hero or fairy tale stuff, he reacts to stuff like Hajime no Ippo, my personal favorite anime, and Berserk. And he's expressive too, not quite as expressive as the previous 2 entries on this list, but he makes up for it with the fun edits he adds in his videos. Whenever something weird happens, he'll like zoom in on his face or add in some weird sound effect, and it's just really enjoyable to watch, making the reactions more interactive feeling. I would have him higher, but again, he's anime only, and there's not really much anime that I like to watch aside from Hajime no Ippo and Berserk and stuff like that. But as for a recommendation, I'll just recommend more anime I like that he might enjoy. Panty and Stocking, Sergeant Frog, Naruto. I know Naruto's a pretty normie show, but whatever. Number 2 is SmurfVlogs. Now, he honestly would have been tied for the number 1 spot in the older days of his channel, but recently there's kind of a reason that pushed him back to number 2 that I'll go into in just a second. Now, I enjoyed his content a lot because of how unique it was. He was reacting to all sorts of old Disney movies that he had never seen before. And just like Kick Butt Reaction's viewing of Coco, I enjoyed it. It was like watching it for the first time all over again. So seeing that with so much more movies with SmurfVlogs was like, oh. And he would upload constantly, keeping track of what movies he hadn't seen. And he was pretty honest. When he had already seen a movie, he'd let us know before the reaction even began. But everything changed when Mickey Mouse attacked. Now, don't get me wrong, Disney had every right to take down his reactions. I mean, he was uploading entire movies and putting ads on top of them. And I mean, he does put a lot of ads on his videos, so clearly he's trying to make some money. But instead of having external links or super tiny minor edits that would help him avoid the copyright, or any of the methods that all the other reactors on this list use, he'd instead coat his reactions in all sorts of video filters or audio filters so he could still make money. To the point where most of them feel completely unwatchable. Come on, SmurfVlogs, I loved your content so much, but doing it for money will definitely keep you from the number one spot. As for recommendations though, definitely keep up with the movies. There's still a few DreamWorks ones you're missing, like the How to Train Your Dragon films, The Croods, and the third Kung Fu Panda. Number 1 is Straw Hat JMP, previously known as JMP Reacts. Honestly, if I were to do this cartoon reaction stuff, my channel would look very, very similar to this. I mean, he's a fan of Regular Show, he's a fan of Total Drama, completing both those series with his consistent content. This dude puts so many episodes into one video and uploads so frequently, I wonder how he does all this stuff. He's also reacted to things like Danny Phantom and Avatar The Last Airbender, but he has had some copyright troubles. He's fought back pretty well though, he has the entirety of both Regular Show and Total Drama back up, and hopefully Danny Phantom and Avatar will soon follow. JMP and I also have very similar brains, to the point where it's pretty creepy actually. Over the summer, Negan from The Walking Dead got announced for Season 2 DLC of Tekken 7, my personal favorite fighting game, so, as a result, I decided to check out The Walking Dead. And just weeks later, what did JMP start reacting to? The Walking Dead. So overall, he's my favorite cartoon reactor to watch, and probably the only one where I actually rewatch their reactions. I don't really have any criticisms or feedback besides just finish re-uploading your old reactions, but keep doing what you're doing, JMP. As for recommendations, just take anything from this final list I'm about to show for all the reactors on this list. Final recommendations. These go for all the reactors I've mentioned today. Except maybe the anime youngin, cause you know anime only, but he could if he wanted to. First up is an older Cartoon Network show, codenamed Kids Next Door. Now for a bit, it seems like this is just another typical kids show, episodic problems that they solve in 11 minutes. But soon enough, plots begin to thicken and connect more, and the lore of this world where kids fight tyrannical adults becomes more rich and detailed. They have rules and explanations for literally everything. How to join the Kids Next Door, how you get kicked out of the Kids Next Door, what do teenagers do, what do adults do, all the different operatives and bases around the world. It's so rich and detailed, and I don't think I've ever seen anyone react to it before, or at least to the point where it gets to the good stuff. Next is more Total Drama and Regular Show. JMP has this covered, and Kick Butt Reactions has Regular Show, but both definitely need more attention. I have a review of Regular Show if you want to check that out to see how good it is, but Total Drama I don't think has any other reactors besides JMP. If there are, please let me know. I'd also like to see them react to more live-action shows and sitcoms. I know this is odd to recommend since this whole video is about cartoon reactors, but stuff like That 70s Show and Drake and Josh with its legendary status would be an absolute riot to watch people react to for the first time if they haven't seen them. Then finally, more animated movies. Like I've expressed tons throughout this list, I enjoy it when reactors do this. Just old movies that I grew up with, watching other people react to it for the first time, it's just entertaining. So definitely more of that from everyone. But not just Disney and Pixar, be sure to get some more DreamWorks in there, or even some Blue Sky, or Aardman. Overall, I'm just a huge fanatic of animation and animation history, so I just enjoy sharing it with all these reactors. And be sure to go check them out yourself if you're a viewer and decided to watch. And if any of these reactors are watching, keep up the good work.